women talking about we coming up. Listen, man, the real truth is because a man allowed that. You understand that? I know I seem a little harsh right now, but I need to be frank with some women. Is it suffice to say that allowing women to raise children has destroyed the unit of family? You don't have to believe me. Look at the condition of the children today. Look at the tradition of the children since the 40s. Look at the condition of the children since wicked patriarchal men have allowed women to take the children with them. The conditions wasn't like that. Crime's going up. Prison time's going up. Teenage pregnancies going up. High school's dropouts going up. Drug abuse, alcohol abuse, rapes. It's all going up. Why? Because you went against the rules and laws of the Most High Adonai. And this is what you get. He told you what you had to do to fix the world. In the book of Malachi 4, verse 6, I would turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and the children to the fathers, not to the mothers. I'm not a misogynist. I'm a realist. This is Yahuwah's work. You can't stop this. You understand that? And you like it, understand it, believe it or not. And any woman, I'm going to tell you something. The only kind of woman that goes against this kind of teaching in my head is a woman that's anti-Christ. You understand? According to the Bible, you're anti-Yahusha. You understand? This is why you can't, oh, I know I got a problem talking. You damn right you do. You have diarrhea of the mouth. Why? Because you got the spirit of Nakash on you. That's the snake that was projected in the Garden of Eden. You should have learned from your foremother Eve, but you didn't. Because you're trying to control the man. You want to rule the man. You have an insatiable, unclean, unnatural desire to try and rule him and not realizing that's part of a curse. You're warring against your own nature that you was created in. You was created to be a helpmeet, to help your man accomplish what he wants, according to the Bible. Now, all you Christian women, you Jewish women, and you Israelite women say, Amon, because it's true. And if that makes you feel uneasy, it's because you're not of the Most High. You're not of this foe. You're pretending. Someone has to say it. So I have to be the one to say it. So you got women that try and trap men like this.
Nigga, you my baby dad. I want all your money. I want y'all support. Nigga, you fuck, dog.
They think that's cute. Yeah, but that's the paradigm. See, it sounds trivial, right? But that's what's going on today, man. So Yahuwah created men to rule their homes, to rule the church, and to rule the world. Men will always rule. Make no mistake about that. Men will always rule. See, the reason that Eve had to protest is because men are in power. And so you got to protest because you're trying to get male attention and say, listen, give us some privileges. I know this sounds harsh. No man has the capacity to speak like this, but you need to hear it. And it's supposed to be that way. It's the natural order of things. The system needs to be changed back to how they were. If Eve wants to leave, let her leave. The children stay with the father because they're better off with the father in most cases. That's a fact, bro. You can't argue that. The court system can't argue that. So why then are these women that's leaving? Check this out. 80% of divorces are executed by women. 80% of the so-called black families are headed by a woman, a single parent that's a woman. Now, so if the children are functional illiterate, and particularly the male children, the average male child all the way up to 12th grade, 90% of them is not proficient in reading. They aren't proficient in reading. You count off 100 men, 90 of them can't read. I'm talking about so-called black men right there. So would you say that these women is bragging about, I don't need a man, has accomplished great? No, she selfishly has focused upon herself, and someone needs to tell her that because that's the only way to fix it is to address the matter that's at hand. I'm not bashing anyone. I'm telling you how to fix your situation. And if you're a woman that want to be happy, you need to get online and submit to your man, because that's the natural order of things. What you got now is a culture, a rape culture, a feminist culture just trying to go against what's natural. See, what's natural is for man to rule his home, to rule the church, and to rule the world. You understand that, Moshea, Helen? You're not supposed to be ruling over no man. Your spirit is off. That's not the spirit of righteousness. It's the spirit of high Shaitan, the devil. Because you got demons on you. You understand that? And some men are just not designed to say this kind of stuff. Because you're not men anymore. Guess why? Because I know when I talk to most people, when I talk to most of you, I'm talking to 80% of people that's been reared by one parent, primarily a single woman, right? And so to you, I'm a misogynist, I'm harsh, because you don't know how to measure masculinity. I get men that trying to argue with, oh man, you're too aggressive. No, I'm not too aggressive, I'm masculine. That's how the Most High in Isaiah 58 and 1 say, cry aloud, lift up thy voice like a trumpet. You understand that? So I'm not here to cater to what you want. I'm here to say what the Most High orders me to do. So men will always rule. It's just, will it be a wicked patriarchal rule or a godly patriarchal rule? See, I refuse to be emasculated or cater to wicked men in society that's pushing feminism. I would never apologize for my masculinity. And you shouldn't either. You shouldn't either. See, we have wicked patriots and not godly ones that's trying to manipulate the world today, and they're doing a pretty good job. I've been sent to turn men back to Yahuwah. I'm a spokesman for men and women that love them. Using a strong masculine father and the encouragement of other male peers in times past was done to create and build confidence and mastery of manhood in young boys. But that's been set aflame. It's been set ablaze by wicked, patriarchal men and feminists. See, in society, right? Think about what I'm saying. Go back and play this 10 times, right? When you look at societies, right? There's always been, men are competitive. Men are made to be rulers, right? So in society, it's always been the wicked patriarchal men against the righteous ones. And that will always be. So men will always rule. It's just a matter of who's going to rule. The wicked patriarchal men that we see running society now, because the earth is under Satan's authority and the prince of this world. The prince of this world cometh and have nothing in me. Yahusha said it. So which are going to rule? ? 80% of fathers are absent. And this is often not by their choice. Male platforms such as this and venues for mutual encouragement are denounced. It's censored, even disallowed. So you tell me right now, I got 96,000 followers. How you got only got 30 on? Now stop me where I'm lying at. Male platforms and venues for mutual encouragement of men to teach men to be masculine, godly men are denounced. They're censored and they're even disallowed, or they're infiltrated by women and girls. Masculine men, manly desires are subdued, or they're redirected by Marxist views, video games. I got you addicted to pornography. Pornography is suicide of your soul, man. You know what I told you? Pornography is suicide of your soul.